Welcome back to my channel. In this video, I'm going to show you everything you need to know to get started with the Slate Material Editor. We'll cover the basics like reading materials and connecting the nodes, as well as more advanced techniques like reading compound objects and organizing the material editor space. So stick around, whether you're a seasoned pro or a beginner. There is something here for everyone. The video is kindly sponsored by Autodesk, who lately updated the Slate Material Editor a lot in 3ds Max 2024. So what is the Slate Material Editor exactly? It is a powerful tool that allows you to create complex materials by connecting different nodes together. It may sound daunting at first, but once you get the hang of it, you'll be creating realistic materials in no time. To turn on the material editor, you can use the M shortcut. In 3ds Max 2024, we can now dock the material editor, which is pretty handy. We just have to hold the window and release the button at the place we want to have it. I think a good combination is to have the material editor on the left-hand side and the viewport on the right-hand side. When creating materials in the scene, it may be useful to have a material editor at the cost of a smaller viewport. In the material editor, we have a menu bar divided into categories, where we can find a bunch of options. Most of them are repeated in other places, and it's more convenient to use them there. Next, we have a toolbar where we can apply materials, for instance. This is a material map browser where we can find all materials and maps needed to create materials in the scene. Next, we have view navigation. And finally, we have parameter editor here, where we can adjust materials and maps. At the bottom, we can find navigator with options that help in working in the active view. Now let me show you how to work with the views. If you want to delete the material, select it and click the delete key. Anyway, view 1 is an active view at the moment. We can create extra views by right-clicking and choosing the create new view option. We can call it exterior materials, for example. We can rename the view as well, so this one can be called interior materials. We can switch between views by clicking on the name. You can create multiple views depending on your needs. We are able to delete the whole view as well. However, you have to remember that if the particular material is not applied to any object in the scene, you will miss this data. Now let's talk about the browser. You can find materials here. Everything is organized. They are divided into categories. In the general group are the standard 3ds Max materials. Others are from the Arnold render engine, which is a built-in 3ds Max renderer. If you use another render engine, the materials will be also listed here and will be in the separate category. Next, we have maps. Similarly, divided into categories to keep things organized. We also have controllers that allow you to animate materials. Let me quickly show you when you can use them. Let's imagine that we have a couple of materials. Now, they have different properties. I change the base color as an example. I add the color correction as an example. And I copy it as well. And now I add another map, let's say it's the noise map. I copy it as well, but this time I change the parameters so we can imagine the scenario. Let's say we want to control some parameters for all of them at once. Right click on the map and choose show all additional parameters. Here you can see the list of all parameters we can change in this map. And now the controllers play a huge role. We may want to change the saturation. We can use linear float, for example. Now, we can type a value. You can see it's changed here as well. We can repeat the procedure and add the same node to all of the maps. This way, we'll control the saturation of all the maps by changing just one parameter instead of adjusting it one by one inside each map. It's pretty useful, for example, when you import some trees and all of them are too dark or bright. Using controllers, you can easily adjust all the leaves materials at once instead of adjusting each material separately. Okay, next we have the scene materials tab. Here, you can find the materials used in the scene. And at the end, you can find a sample slot that lets you maintain and preview materials and maps. To create the material, we can drag and drop it from the browser into the active view. It works similarly for maps. Just drag and drop whatever you need. Now, when we double-click on the material, we can adjust its parameters. In this case, we can, for example, change the color. You can notice that we automatically see the update of the changes here. We can also change different values to achieve desired effect. Another method of adding map is holding the mouse on the node output and choosing the map from here. The good thing about this method is that the nodes are automatically connected. Otherwise, we have to connect them manually. Then we have to click on the parameter output, hold the mouse button and release it when we are on top of the output we want. We can also search by name. We only need to type the name of the material or map we want to find. Then we have to drag and drop it from the drop list rollout. And again, we have to connect the map to a particular parameter output. Additionally, we can right-click on the active view and choose materials and maps from here. We can add multiple maps creating a material structure. Similarly, like with materials, we can edit maps in the parameter editor. Depending on the map, we'll have different options and possibilities here. We just need to double-click on the map and then adjust its parameters. For instance, changing saturation of the map in this case. The materials parameters will vary as well. Here, for example, we have Maps tab where we can turn on and off maps if we need to. If you want to make the material more compact, we can click on the minus icon. If you want to go back to the full display, we can click here again. When we double-click on the preview, it becomes bigger so we can better see the changes. We can see more options by right-clicking on the material or map. For example, we can rename the material. You can see that the name changed here. We can also rename it from here. Another useful option is Open Preview Window. It is handy when we work on the materials and we want to see changes more clearly. You can update the preview manually if you need to optimize your scene. Typically, the default auto-update is the best solution though. We can also change the object type in the preview. It can be a cylinder or box, but I like the sphere the most. Turning the background in preview is a must, as otherwise we cannot really see what is going on. Look at this, now we can see the reflections. We can adjust the reflections easily at the moment. Using the material ID channels can be pretty handy for post-production. If you want to learn more about it, watch my video about render elements. Besides, we can also add materials to material library. To move maps and materials, we have to have the select tool turned on. Then we need to click on the map, and by holding the mouse button, we can move it wherever we want. We can move more than one node. We just need to select what we want and move it the same way. When we want to copy something inside Material Editor, we have to hold it with Shift. We can copy individual nodes as well as multiple maps and materials. To delete, use Delete key. Now, click on the map first, move it, and click Ctrl on top of the node. This way, you will connect it in between two other nodes. It saves time, as you don't have to plug and unplug everything. By moving the scroll wheel forward and backward, you zoom in and out of view. By holding the mouse scroll wheel on another side, you can move around the view. You can also use the navigator to move around the active view. You can see the brighter rectangle. This is an area we currently see in the active view. You can notice that changing the position of the materials and maps is automatically updated there as well. We have some handy selection options here as well. Select a material, go to Select, and choose Select Tree, for instance. It selects the whole material structure. When we choose Deselect Children, it will deselect all child nodes of the currently selected node. And Select Children is the opposite of the previous action. We can find these options by right-clicking on the node. At the right bottom, we can find some extra options. We can change the scale to see less or more of the view. This is the same as holding the mouse scroll wheel. With this option, we can select what we want to zoom in. This option zooms out the view so we can see all the nodes. Here, all the selected nodes in the view are visible and centered. And the last one pans the view to the currently selected node. We can of course add maps to different slots. To apply the material, we need to have an object in the scene. Now select the material and click this icon. You can notice that the material is applied. We can use another method. Let me copy the material and make a quick adjustment so you can see the result. You can also apply the material by clicking on the parameter output and holding the mouse button, next move, and release on top of the object you want to add the material on. Now, I show you how to pick the material. Click this icon and click on the object you want to pick the material from. Here it is. We have the material in the material editor. One more useful thing is using the scene materials rollout. Here, remember to use the instance option if you want to have exact material from the object, not not a copy of this. Now, we can edit it and it will influence all the objects to which the material is applied on. Now let's talk about other options in the toolbar. To show you the option, I need to create another object. I apply the same material as on the sphere. Now I copy the material and change its name to the same name as the original one. And now click this icon, put material to scene. So when you have a copy of material that has the same name as a material applied to objects and use this option, all the objects that have the older material applied to them will be replaced with the new one. The next tool we can use to delete materials and maps. It's the same as using the delete key. The Move Children tool is pretty handy. When this option is on, moving a parent node moves the child nodes along with the parent. We can simply click on the last one we want and all the nodes that are lower in the material structure will be selected automatically. This option makes the unused node slots hidden. It's good to use when you want to keep things organized, especially when you have many materials in view. Show map in viewport allows you to show maps in viewports. As we have the material without the map applied, you can see just the color. But when we apply another material, the checker map is visible on the objects. If you turn on this button, it will add a multicolored checkered background to the preview window for the selected material. Here, you can change the IDs of the material. Layout Flayout lets you choose the orientation of the automatic layout in the active view. By default, the vertical layout is chosen. If you hold this button though, you will get another option, horizontal layout. The second option, on another hand, automatically layers the children of the currently selected node. This doesn't change the position of the parent node. And the next buttons turn on and off the windows. Thanks to the last one, you can look for the objects in the list. The workflow I am going to show you now is possible from 3ds Max 2024. When working on complex materials with lots of maps, you can use compound nodes. It is here to help you organize your view. To create a compound object, you have to select the maps you want to have in the compound, right-click and choose the Package Nodes in Compound option. You can notice that all the maps we selected are hidden in one node. If you want to go inside the structure, just double-click on the compound. You can see that we additionally have these extra purple outputs. These are the slots that will be outside the compound. To go back to our active view, click Exit. You can see these output parameters here. We can also create nested compounds, which basically are the compounds inside the compounds. We can go inside the same way as previously. At the top, we have a structure listed, so we can go back to different compounds if we need to. Or exit completely. Materials also can be included in the compound. Select everything, right-click, and choose the right option. However, you can notice that we don't have the output here. So go back to the compound, click on the output parameter, and choose the expose as output parameter. And now we can plug the material into another material, for example, multi-sub material. We can do the same operations as on materials, for example, copying the compound and adding the copies to different slots. This way we have a much cleaner view and working on complex materials is a piece of cake in terms of organization. If for some reason we want to unpack the compound, we just need to right-click and choose the Unpackage Compound option. By the way, in 3ds Max 2024, we can now color manage the material editor. If you want to learn more about this, watch my video tutorial about updates in 3ds Max 2024. To create library, we need to select the material, right-click and choose Add to Material Library. As I don't have any library created yet, I have to create a new one. You can see it's now visible here. You can add various of materials here and then reuse them in different scenes. They will be here where you open the new MAX file. This way, you can add the most common materials you use often like asphalt, concrete and so on. And then you can adjust them if needed. Creating groups is pretty handy and I highly recommend doing it. Right-click here and choose New Group. Name it however you like. And now you can drag and drop all materials you use the most often here. We can do the same with maps, of course. Let me change the name of this group to Favorite Materials. And I create a new one called Favorite Maps and drag and drop some maps there. When you right-click on the active view, you will be able to access your groups and libraries from here as well. This speeds up the workflow a lot, so it's definitely worth creating yours. In the Scene Material panel is a similar situation. We can update automatically or manually. If you don't have issues with your scene, there is no reason to use the update option. Using the filter selected objects comes pretty handy. First of all, you can locate materials just from the selected objects pretty easily. Also, it doesn't have to load all the materials from the scene then. We can also save the materials that are here as a new material library. If you struggle with a lagging scene, changing your display group to text may be a great solution as your GPU doesn't have to render all these maps here. If you want to learn more about visualizations, join our visualization training. To learn more about the updates done in 3ds Max 2024, watch the video in the top corner. Bye bye!